Do you pray even when you're busy? Good morning, everyone. This is our reflection question for today. Peggy Noonan, in her book, When Character Was King, shares a fascinating story about President Reagan and his belief in prayer. Do you know about his ulcer? Nancy Reagan asked me. We were talking about his early days in the governorship. He came home a few months into his new job, looked at Nancy, and said he didn't feel good. He told me, I spent 13 years at Warner Brothers and they didn't give me an ulcer, but I think I'm getting one now. And he was. It was a sharp pain in his stomach that wouldn't go away. His doctor examined him and confirmed it. Reagan wasn't sure when it started, but he thought it was when he started to worry about running for governor. He was embarrassed. He thought an ulcer was a sign of weakness, and he kept it a secret from everyone but the family and a few friends. It hung on for more than a year and got worse, until one morning before leaving the house, he reached for the malocs, and something inside him said, you don't need this anymore. So he put down the bottle and didn't take his medicine before he left. Later that morning, he had a meeting in his office with a man from Southern California who had a problem he wanted to discuss. As he left, he turned to Reagan and said, Governor, you might like to know I'm part of a group of people who meet every day and pray for you. Reagan was taken aback, thanked him, and said he also put a lot of stock in prayer. Later the same day, he met up with another man, this one from North Carolina. And as he was leaving the governor, he turned around and said he met with a group of people who prayed for him daily. Soon after, Reagan went back to the doctor for a checkup. The doctor poked and prodded and said, I don't think you have an ulcer anymore. When more tests came in, he said there was no sign there had ever been an ulcer. Later, Reagan thought it was the power of prayer that had kept him from taking the medicine, that had told him he didn't need it anymore. It was the power of prayer that had healed his ulcer. In the Gospel of Luke, he frequently mentions Jesus praying, but in today's Gospel reading, instead of hieing off to a deserted place, this time he was praying alone in the presence of his disciples. Jesus teaches us today to pray in solitude even when we are busy. He can be in a deep, prayerful communion with God even in the busyness of his day. For us, we pray better when the environment is conducive to prayer, when we are alone in front of our altar, when the lights are dim and there is soft meditation music playing. We pray better when we are blanketed by nature, when there is that sunset in front of us in a beachfront, or when we are seated in the patio of a house overlooking a well-manicured lawn with birds chirping in the background. Yes, these are beautiful moments to commune with God. But Jesus teaches us that prayer is possible even in the din of the crowd, in the busyness of our day, inside the bus, as we drive, while in a restaurant, during a meeting, while doing household chores. Prayer is about being attentive to God's presence and giving our full attention to Him, even for a short while, to ask Him for a quick help, to thank Him for a prayer answered, to praise Him for the moment of His presence. When after praying, Jesus asked his apostles two questions about who people think he is and who they think he is, perhaps his prayer shaped the words that came out of his lips. Our prayer shapes our countenance, our words, our deeds. Even if we are not aware of it, the more prayerful we are in praise and thanksgiving, the more we become positive about life and about our own situation. As we pray, we open up ourselves to God's loving and powerful presence, and the more we spend even fleeting moments of communing with Him, the more we are able to think, feel, speak, and act in the way of God, and the ulcers of life just fade away as we discover that our mind and heart are healed by a growing love for Him when we constantly dispose ourselves to pray. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, grant me the grace to always be conscious of your loving presence in my midst. Allow me to experience you in my day, so that I may imitate you. This I pray in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic faith and couples for Christ.